revolution will be live.
Do a voter ID law to try to push something like that through Congress.
Look, we're looking to do everything we can at this point to protect the 2018 elections, the integrity of those elections, and moving on beyond 2018 to 2020 and after. We haven't made a final decision, but certainly looking at every option available to us. It's not unreasonable. If I return something to a department store, if I have to cash a check, I have to show my ID in order to do those things. It's not outrageous that if you're going to vote to decide on who the leaders of the local communities, your state, and the federal government are going to be, that you would be asked to show an ID. Jim?
I just wanted to follow up on Sarah's question from NPR. She asked you about Ivanka Trump's statement that the press is not the enemy of the people. And she asked you whether or not the press is the enemy of the people. You read off a laundry list of your concerns about the press and things that you feel like are misreported, but you did not say that the press is not the enemy of the people. And I think it would be a good thing if you were to say right here at this briefing that the press, the people who are gathered in this room right now, doing their jobs every day, asking questions of officials like the ones you brought forward earlier, are not the enemy of the people. I think we deserve that.
I think the president has made his position known. I also think it's ironic.
Would you mind telling us,
I'm trying to answer your question. Okay, well, I politely waited, and I even called on you despite the fact that you interrupted me while calling on your colleague.
Well,
I said it's ironic.
Which is why I interrupted.
I'm trying.
But if you finish, if you would not mind letting me have a follow-up, that would be fine. But
it's ironic, Jim, that not only you and the media attack the president for his rhetoric when they frequently lower the level of conversation in this country. Repeatedly, the media resorts to personal attacks without any content other than to incite anger. The media has attacked me personally on a number of occasions, including your own network, said I should be harassed as a life sentence, that I should be choked. ICE officials are not welcomed in their place of worship, and personal information is shared on the internet. When I was hosted by the Correspondents Association, of which almost all of you are members of, you brought a comedian up to attack my appearance and call me a traitor to my own gender. In fact, as I know, I'm the first press secretary in the history of the United States that's required Secret Service protection. The media continues to ratchet up the verbal assault against the president and everyone in this administration, and certainly we have a role to play, but the media has a role to play for the discourse in this country as well.
If I may follow up, you did not say in the course of those remarks that you just made that the press is not the enemy of the people. Are we to take it from what you just said? We all get put through the ringer. We all get put in the meat grinder in this town, and you're no exception. And I'm sorry that that happened to you. I wish that had not happened. But for the sake of this room, the people who are in this room, this democracy, this country, all the people around the world are watching what you're saying, Sarah, and the White House for the United States of America, the President of the United States should not refer to us as the enemy of the people. His own daughter acknowledges that, and all I'm asking you to do, Sarah, is to acknowledge that right now and right here.
I appreciate your passion. I share it. I've addressed this question. I've addressed my personal feelings. I'm here to speak on behalf of the President. He's made his comments clear.
On another matter, the National Archives told the Senate Judiciary Committee chairman today that they probably aren't going to be able to finish up the document collection regarding Brett Kavanaugh until October. That's obviously later than the timetable I know you guys and Senate Republicans are hoping for. Any comment on that or any potential assistance that the White House can give the archives in accelerating that?
Certainly, we want to be as helpful as possible in turning over as many documents. Several senators have stated there will be up to and over a million pages of documents to review, including over 300 judicial opinions. His documents as staff secretary tell us the least about his judicial thinking than the million pages from his other work, including his judicial opinions. We want a thorough evaluation. We've asked for that, but we don't want a taxpayer-funded fishing expedition. We want to continue to be cooperative, and that's exactly what we're going to do. I'll take a last question, Jordan.
One more for the right side.
Thanks, Sarah. I want to follow up on the third part of Jill's question from earlier on North Korea. We're nearing now the two-month mark from the Singapore summit. So is the president satisfied with the progress North Korea is making toward denuclearization?
The president won't be completely satisfied until all of Korea has been denuclearized. We're going to continue moving forward. We've seen steps of progress and continued cooperation. We're incredibly grateful and thankful for the remains of the service members that were returned yesterday. And we're going to continue to work with North Korea. I think that's a great place to close out. Thanks so much, guys. Have a good day.
Are you going to sanction the 13th?
All right.
The revolution will be live.